Okay, I have a video for you. This video got erased the first time, so I'm doing it again of my US postal stamps machine. Vintage, I guess you would say. I don't know exactly how old it is, but this might tell you 1 to 20, 1 to 10 cents, 1 to 5 cents, and then 1 to 20, 1 to 10 again. And these are all, it's all functioning. And the only thing about it that's messed up is someone picked the lock in the antique store, or broke it, I should say, to where it's really hard to shut. Nothing too special. This is the back. It just has some wall mounts, no paper or anything. I have a cord or two, and that's for a reason. Let me show you it working first. I think this is the, no, that's the one that has the guard in it. Not the quarter in. And you take that out. Obviously, it worked. I'm not gonna use the little coin things. There's nothing else in here. No writing or anything. This is all just a galvanized tin, maybe. Here it is. I'll show you the workings now. And yes, we're doing a review under my fish tank. Let's see, some pointers that I've gotten about it. I haven't done really any research. This sat on top of the stamps. It's lead. Love lead. Sat on top of the stamps, like in here, see? Then as the stamps get fed, it just pushed them in. When you ran out of stamps, this little finger thing would come and push that copper thing, see, down. And all that does, can you see that? Well, you can probably see it over here. See the copper thing? That keeps you from putting money in. It has it on all of them. See, here's another one. Here's the metal ones, metal thing. Oh, it's hard to get out of here. There we go. Sweet, middle one's metal thing. And then here is this one's metal thing. And all of them have the copper little coin operated thingies. No, it's hard to see because it's dark. And I'm just going to take it all out for the point of the video. See, paper interchangeable things. That's that price tag you saw with the money. All spring loaded, nice and clean. $5, by the way. Nice piece of machinery. I guess I'll show it to you working now. At the back off. I'm going to put it in the side one over here. Because it's probably... No, I'll put it in this one because it's the best to see. So the far right. So you drop in the coin. Alright, see? Coin is in there. Then you press down on the lever. And then the coin pops out here. And that all of them do work. I'll just do it for the rest of them. I just did this one, but I'll do it again. And by the way, when there's no coin in it, it only goes down half. When there is a coin, it goes down the full way. I'll do the 5 cent one next. Wrong lever. Let me get the coin. Then last this one. This is that one that's slightly buggered up. I have an airplane. That didn't work. Well, let's see. Here we go. Alright, I have some test wires off of this. There you go. Just needed to fall back. Alright. This one still works. And here's your coin. So, anyway, nothing else really to say. That's just the coin catch box. And, yeah. It's my vintage postal stamp machine. If you have any questions, comments, or anything, feel free to ask or say. on my channel, Mr. Three Wheeled Bikes channel. And eventually, I'm going to be doing a video of why my name's called that. And there is a three-wheeled biking call involved, but not a children's tricycle. So...